Okay, guys. So this is how I kill Nasdaq. Always when I trade Nasdaq nowadays, I use the line chat. So when I'm in the line chat, guys, I'm going to spot my levels, you know. I'm going to spot my levels, my most important levels. So Nasdaq is like this. So when you come to these levels, you can see head and shoulder setups and everything. So I use some horizontal raise most of the time. So I'll show you how we do this. So that's the first horizontal read that I have. That is the lowest on the market. This is the highest. So when I have my lowest and highest, guys, I'll analyze inside the market. So if you can check here, we have this here. That's an important level. Remember, we even have the previous level. That was an important level. So the thing, the story or the key based on this one here, that's what is the key levels. So I identify those key levels because they're important, they understand. So I start from the 4 hour, then I'll be going to the 1 hour. So here's my analysis, it looks like that. But then remember, guys, there's some levels which we can't identify on the higher time frame, but we can identify on the shorter time frame. So from here, if we can like switch to the 1 hour time frame, for me the most important time frames when trading Nasdaq is the 4 hour, the 1 hour, the M30, M15. You understand, guys? So let's check. If you can check this drop of Nasdaq, we knew it was gonna happen. Why? Because first confirmation that I have, it's an inverse, it was a H&S setup, and I predicted this head and shoulder setup in a long time, you know, that was supposed to happen. So to those who are like investors in the market, they probably know, good see, okay, this thing was going to happen like this. As you can see, the market is respecting those levels, guys. So from the 1 hour, I'll be going to the 30 minutes. From 1 hour to 30 minutes. So on the 30 minutes time frame, we are going to even check the levels again. For Nasdaq to sell, I see two confirmation. First confirmation is the double top on that level. Okay, guys, so now I'm on the M30. From the M30, I'll be going to the M15. Like most of the time, I don't trade the Nasdaq using trend lines. Most of the time, because I understand how it moves. So here, basically, we had a double top. You understand? So I'm going to switch from the line chart, guys, to what? To the candlesticks. You understand? So if you can check, these are the candlesticks. The market have been respecting our levels. Okay, we're going to start from the M30. So from the M30, if you can check, from here, the market rejected this level. And it rejected that level, it did what? It went down. So for me to show you that this thing is working, I will show you with the 1 hour time frame. On the 1 hour time frame, I knew what was gonna happen. You understand? I knew that there was a head and shoulder setup. I even have this this setup on my other private Instagram account, which is for my business. If you can check here, guys, it was a picture-perfect head and shoulder setup. As we said previously with Prince, that Nasdaq will come to this level. After reaching that level, then you're going to drop. And, guys, this is nothing. We're still going to drop. Why? So this is where I'll use what trend line strategy. For your trend line to be correct, remember, you need to have two to three connects. So as you can see, starting from here, I have my two, number three, we did break. So after the break, we're going to retest this level. And after retesting this level, then we go down. You understand, guys? So that's how I analyze Nasdaq, you know. So you should ask those mentors to show you the Nasdaq strategy that they're talking about. Okay, this was the Nasdaq video. It was a picture perfect one. You understand, guys? So I hope everyone understands how I trade it. And guys, if you have a question, you can ask on the comment section while I'm still here, because when you text me privately, it's not gonna be it's not gonna be nah. Like, people tend to say I'm rude. I'm not rude when it comes to inboxes and everything. Like, yo, that's a problem for me to communicate. So, guys, you can tell me. If you didn't understand, tell me. And if you did, tell me. Oh, wait. So, guys, did you understand the thing? Can you please save the life? Yeah, I'm gonna save this live video. I'm gonna save this live video. So, to those who have questions before I leave, I'm late. Please save the live video. Yeah, I'm gonna save the live video for everyone who came late. So, to everyone who didn't understand, you would see on the live video. And to those who have questions, you can ask the questions here. You know, this is how it is. So, and if there is another pair which you love me to do for you now, we could check it before I go out. If you have a question, ask me now, or keep it into your heart for the rest of your life. Cause I don't really talk about Forex on the inboxes and everything most of the time. So, if you have any question, ask now, guys, because this is for you guys, you know. This is for everyone. Oh, yeah. Yes, I'm gonna save this live video, guys. The knowledge which was shared here, we should save it. So here's my... Okay, let me just show you with one currency. I haven't been trading currency, but I'm just gonna analyze NZD something. NZD something. Let's see. Okay, let's go with NZD JPY. So after analyzing NZD JPY, I'm gonna leave the live because I'll have to be busy. So okay, guys, when you're analyzing currency, I advise people to start from the weekly. So when you're in the weekly time frame, you'll have to figure out the structure. You figure out the structure from what? From the weekly. But then checking from my side here on the weekly time frame, okay, I'm having something like this. So when I'm having something like that on the weekly time frame, it means I'm gonna be having my highest level and lowest level. So I'll use a horizontal ray. This is my highest level. Remember, I said on the weekly, that's my highest level. And this is my lowest level. So when this is my highest and lowest level, what is my structure here? I'm going to go to the daily. So on the 1 day time frame, that's where I'm going to get what my structure. And as you can see, guys, the market is playing within these levels, you know, so it won't be an easy analysis. So from there, we can go down, and as long as you have 1, 2, 3, or you have more than, you just need more than 2 to 3 connects for your setup to be okay. Understand? You need 2 to 3 connects for your setup to be okay. As you can see, I have a 1 and a 2, it's almost 1, 2, 3. Then okay, it's fine, I'm not done. Then from here, going down, you can see, guys, that we do have what? We do have that level. So from this level to this level is the same. But then if you want to keep your analysis as clean as possible, you can like come and connect where? And connect to this level. Understand? So now you have a what? You have a perfect You have a perfect thought. You have a perfect touches. So, okay. Remember, when you're analyzing, guys, you're taking your time. You know, you're enjoying yourself. Get yourself a cup of tea. Go deep into the market. Then when you zoom in the market, we're going to be having that thing. So the thing that you see there, it's a what? It's a pattern. So, okay, we're going to come. And, like, if you check, we have 1, 2, 3 pattern. So after the 1, 2, 3 pattern, we are forming what? We are forming another 1, 2, 3 pattern. Here's the another 1, 2, 3 pattern. So when it's like this, you can check that the market is going to reach where it's going to push to this level, then we come down. That's the, what time frame is it? That's the daily. So now I'm into the 4 hour now. So on the 4 hour time frame, remember, guys, I'll always keep it real with you, ne? The third touch has the highest probability in the market. You understand? So before I sleep, I'll invite Dr. Martin to the live so we can, like, break down the analysis for you guys. 1, 2, this is the third touch, you know. So the third touch has the highest probability. You understand? So if you check on the third touch exactly, the market dropped. Niabo. So from the daily, I'll be going to the 1 hour. So on the 1 hour, if you can check, let our structure not run. Remember, I was analyzing currency. I started on which time frame? I started on the bigger time frame. Which was the other layer? Which was the weekly. So now I'm in the 1 hour time frame. Take time, guys. Take time to like analyze the market. Don't just rush your entries. You understand? Don't rush your entries. Now I'm into the 1 hour time frame. You understand? So let me tell you what's a fool, leh. A fool is someone who enters a buy here. You understand? Because you need to confirm. You understand? From I have my 1, 2, 3. The third touch has the highest probability, as I always say. So we enter based on the trend line. We don't trade the market inside. You understand? So now we're expecting what? We're expecting a push. You know, we're expecting a push to this level. Then we can go down. So the last time frame that I go for confirmation is the M15. You know, when I'm trading currency, M15 is the time frame that I go to. You know, for my confirmations and everything. Then I go to M15. Got bra M15. Then sir, bra M15. I'm an uptrend. So you're in an uptrend, my guy. He said, yes, I'm an uptrend. Okay, so we had a trend. That was our trend on the M15. Guys, this is how you spot perfect entries. People have been asking, how do we spot perfect entries? 1, 2, third touch has the highest probability to enter on the third touch. So, okay, something interesting happened there. When that thing happens, so it also happened that we had the what? We had another what confirmation. We had a confirmation of a what? Of a double bottom. So, okay, remember, my first trade was going to be based here. So when my first trade is based here, then I was going to have another opportunity to enter. So here's what's going to happen. The market makers are too powerful. You know, when you're in this level, they're going to test your faith. Your mentor is going to send you signal, buy signals. Then it drops to this level. Then you did blow your account. Then the market goes up, you know. Then you're going to say what? You're going to say, ah, my mentor is full of shit. He claims to be making money while we not making money. You understand? So from that time frame, I'll go back to the 4 hour. 4 hour, that's where I'm going to hold my trade. Understand? Then I check during the day. Like, you don't have to be on the market every day. You just need to, like, understand what the market is doing, you know. So if you know what the what's happening in the market, you don't have to be worried. You understand? About what, just plan the trade and trade the plan, you know, guys. Most of you guys said you have never seen me analyzing, you know. So that's why I decided to, like, dedicate this day and analyze the market for you, you know. The greatest thing that one can, like, do in the market is to, like, push the forecast, you know, like, push the consistency. Any pair that you can tell me, I'll analyze it, you know. And you can't come to me saying, Manando, teach me, I tell you that I have a different strategy.
Oh, this was NZDJPY. Lantalo Haj, you can't come to me and I say, you know what, when trading this, I have a different strategy. You know, we all analyze, but then we analyze in a different way. But the biggest thing that can like happen is when we all get what the direction. Lantalo Haj, I did see that movie on Nasdaq, you know. I predicted that movie, but I didn't trade it. You know, so the things that I do here, guys, I've learned them. I've learned them, go YouTube and other things, you know. Nasdaq, we did analyze it. It was the first trade that we did, you know. So, guys, I'm giving you the opportunity to go live with me. Analyze with me. Let me teach you. Let me tell you when you're what where you're wrong, you understand? What pair was this? It was NZDJPY, guys. You understand, guys? Skill is too much, you know. Skill is too much. So the biggest thing, guys, fear. Remove the fear in you. You don't really need to pay for mentorship. People hate me for those words. You understand? So, okay, I'll be checking the last pair, guys. Then I'm out of this live video, you know, because I have to do some things. I have videos to watch. Okay, let's see how GBP USD can go. Understand, guys? Skill is too much. All right, guys. Here's GBP. Here's GBP. Here's GBP USD. So on GBP USD, as I said, with currency, always start on the 1 week. When you're in the 1 week, zoom in so you can see the structure. Oh wait. Zoom in so that you can see the structure. As you can see, we can see that this structure, we have something like this. 1, 2, 3. This is, I call it the Falcon Arc. So when I have the Falcon Arc, alright, it's fine. I'm going in again. Remember, guys, 3 touches has the highest probability. Then I use this one here again as a trend line. So now 1, 2, 3 with the arc, that's a strong confirmation. So remember, it's the weekly. As I go to the daily, the structure will start appearing. Understand? The structure will start showing you, you know what? You know what you're doing. As you can see, here is again. This is what. Okay, this is how it goes. If you can check. If you check, there's something interesting. Remember, we did the analysis on the weekly, but then on the daily, the analysis shows Oguti what's happening. So again, we have our nice 1, 2, 3. You understand? So when we have our nice 1, 2, 3 there up, I'm going to draw my trend line again, starting where? From the lower level. You know, so from the lower level, which is here, I do have the 1, 2, 3 nice touches. Then I'll move to the 4 hour. Guys, as we trade in different ways. As I think I have almost 23 minutes on this live, but I haven't talked about support and resistance because I don't trade support and resistance, you know. So if you can check again, guys, on this thing here, we have an inverse head and shoulder setup. So when we have an inverse head and shoulder setup, we know what happens when there's an inverse head and shoulder setup. You know, from the 4 hour, I'm gonna run to the 1 hour. I understand. From the 1 hour, okay, I'm just gonna unzoom on the 1 hour. Then after the unzoom on the 1 hour, then I'm gonna just stretch the market and see what happens. So on this one, I can see that the market went for a retracement of what shoulder that I was telling you with. Okay, yeah, we do have a structure. So this structure, if it breaks, we're going down. So the last time frame I'm gonna go, guys, as always, is the M15. So in the M15, I'm gonna even check again. You see, in the M15, the market will do as we say it will, because the market was moving in an impulse way. Then this was a correction. So on that correction, we're gonna be having a long position. But then, guys, there are those who are mixing the way we trade with support and resistance, and it's working for them.
You know, so for me to say support and resistance doesn't work for me, doesn't mean it won't work for everyone. If you are really using it and it's working, we're gonna say nice, that's good for you, we understand, because so this is how it is. Complete setup on the 4 hour where we monitor our trades. You understand? So I'm a nigga with clean charts, guys. I don't use indicators, I don't use systems, you know. It's a nigga with clean charts. So this was the setup on what do you call this? This was a setup on GBP USD. And remember, no support, no resistance. So this is how it goes. And guys, I'll tell you about these things of Bloomberg. I'll explain about Bloomberg when it comes to Nasdaq. So this is the complete setup. So the complete setup is like that, which is a picture perfect one. Okay, so now let's talk about Bloomberg. Bloomberg is an app. There's a free version and there's a paid version on Bloomberg. So what really happens on Bloomberg is, it's what you call, on Bloomberg, what really happens is there's a free subscription and there's a paid subscription. But what you need to know is free subscriptions and paid subscriptions will never be the same. So to those who are paying Bloomberg and they're paying 350 480 rand per month, in a year it's 5,500. They're getting the real time news and everything, unlike you guys who are on free trials. You know, those news they work on Nasdaq when you're paying them, but then if you're on a free version, it's not gonna work for you. Understand, guys? So it's just a matter of like digging the information before you come, you know, because if you check Bloomberg, Bloomberg is legit. Bloomberg is, it's really working. And guys, the market, the people who control the market is Trump. If you follow Trump more and understand what Trump says, you'll see the market, you'll see the true nature of the market. When Trump says this, you understand me, guys? When you say this, the market moves. You see, like, niggas like Trump are the niggas that controls the market. Yeah, boom. Because each and everything that they say, whatever happens in the Trump things, the market moves, you know. So they are fundamental traders and they are support and they are technical traders. So I'm a technical trader. And guys, fundamental doesn't change the market structure. You see, when you're in a fundamental thing, it's just a spike that the market does. Fundamental doesn't change the market structure. Fundamentals doesn't change the market's direction. If there's a head and shoulder during NFP, the market is gonna sell. You understand? So fundamentals doesn't really change the market structure. So, and what really works is candlesticks. You need to understand the rejections of candlesticks. The rejections of candlesticks, they're a lot, guys. And there's this thing that I always wanted to show you. If we can check on the screen, there are a lot of people that you can like subscribe to their channels. You understand? So this is real free knowledge. You understand? So you don't have to pay for classes, because we know that we're getting scammed always. If you can check here, this is the triangle chart patterns technical analysis. You understand? So those are the guys that you need to follow. You know, because if you can check, it's just a simple way of trading. But then you pay 3,000 just to learn something so simple. Technical patterns, you understand, guys? So most of my knowledge really before is, I went to like Falcon, it came from YouTube, because YouTube has the best mentors. Remember, with YouTube we have different people on YouTube which trades different ways, you understand? And as you can see here, guys, I've been uploading. This is my channel. This is my YouTube channel. So I just uploaded a few videos because they didn't really take it serious. But then to other people, they're benefiting. You understand? To other people, they're benefiting. You can check my channel on YouTube. It's under Manando the Goat, you know. So if you wanna, brothers, the third touch. Bro, does the third touch also start? Guys, the third touch is the most important touch. Guys, I'm done with this live video. I hope everyone is good. What happened to the mentors who were telling people to buy Nasdaq and delete Metaphor?
Now I'll never give a signal and say delete metaphor. I'm not Jesus at the end of the day. I'm just a young boy from Emakhaya. You know, you can't tell someone to buy Nasdaq and delete metaphor. Nasdaq will humble you. Understand? Nasdaq will humble you. Nasdaq will leave you broke. Nasdaq will... I can say a lot of things about Nasdaq. So when someone says buy Nasdaq and relax, be aware. You understand, guys? And like catalysts are technical. Yeah, so you can't buy Nasdaq and relax. Nasdaq moves like an M4. Nasdaq moves like a C63S. Nasdaq moves like a lot of things. You know, guys, now I love sharing knowledge because I've been in the game. I understand the struggle, you know. A lot of people tend to follow traders who do different things, understand? A lot of traders tend to follow traders who, like, driving in most expensive car doesn't mean you can, like, trade Forex. Let them come to the charts with you. Let them explain the charts and everything. And talohanya, guys. Okay, before I leave this live video, let me repeat one thing about Nasdaq. That Nasdaq thing, guys, it was an open H&S setup. You know, you didn't really need any system to spot that thing. And talohanya, guys, you didn't really need a system to spot that thing. Because if you check, let me go to that Nasdaq thing. You didn't really need anything. That's no shit like that. Because that thing, it was an open thing. That even, SME, you're getting knowledge from SA traders and more. I see nonsense. Okay, so let me show you something here, on Nasdaq. Guys, Nasdaq created a head and shoulder setup. You know, like there's some things now I saw, like I can show you my previous setup on Nasdaq. Now I really knew that Nasdaq was selling. You know, system said buy Nasdaq and you bought Nasdaq and Nasdaq humbled you. Eh? Then now you're thinking Ubuntu Forex is a scam. It's not a scam. Okay, let's check Nasdaq. Guys, Nasdaq was like this, ne? I remember, I can still look for that setup. I had this setup on Nasdaq. This was my left shoulder. This is my right shoulder. This was my head. This was my other shoulder. And this was my right shoulder. And this is what happened. Guys, you see, this is a skill. It's nothing personal. Ki skill fela ju. Ntlalohanya. Ki skill fela ju. There's nothing personal here. It was just a skill fela. I analyzed that setup few days ago. You understand? So I had it. You know. So who should I block, man, you guys? Because I'm not into the comment section. Kiss skilly fair, nothing personal. I don't even see the guy you say I should block. And tell her, kiss skilly my feet. Ke skill di deng ase system di khutis ke skill di khutis ase system di khutis. I had this analysis. I'll show you guys. Now don't, like, guys, the comment section will always be the comment section. Don't mind people on the comment section. As long as you have that knowledge and everything, let's kabelela with the people, you understand? So this thing was an open head and shoulder setup, guys. Len tlalohanya ke skill fela. Oh boy, you didn't need a system to see such things. Hey, it's just that I don't have all day. If I had all day, I'll fertilize. So guys, it is what it is. Let's keep pushing. Pray for consistency. Keep 1 hour time frame. You know, not everyone's gonna do free things, you know. It's not everyone's gonna do free things because people are busy promoting things that they know that it's gonna make money for them, you know. So now in SA, it's just a matter of who has this and who has that, you know, guys. And you're not saying, no, I'm not a bad person at all. I just love the reality shit, yeah, bro. We just stick to reality, keeping it 100. Keeping it 100. Now, I'm sure, like, if I get kidnapped with some good traders and they say the passport to leave or to be free was to grow a small account, I was going to go out of that thing. You understand? Your own, guys, let me tell you something. You don't pray for skill. You work for the skill. You understand? There's no way, guys. You can't be like me, ne? Listen, you can't be like me if you're not working like me. You know, it's useless. Let's check this thing and say it's US state. You can't ask God for blessings while you're not like praying. You can't ask. There are a lot of things, guys. What happened to the life with Dr. Martin? I'm still gonna contact him first. Cause he's a busy man. Hey, I wanna be a good trader. You wanna be a good trader, yes. If you're putting 3 minutes on the chat, you're gonna get paid 3 minutes on the charts. You understand? Life should be that simple. Let's show you something. Check this one, guys. This one, it was a simple one. Again, in Ayo. Just trend lines. US state. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. Third touch is the highest probability. When you see the third touch, always think about Manando. 1, 2, third touch. Market went down. Until high. So guys, let me just save this live video. Next time, Bafit, I'm gonna save this live video. It was nice having some of you on the live. May God be with you in this FX journey, and may you see light. Yeah, the last hope in your family. Keep more work. Until high. Keep more work. There is no luck in Forex. Hey, negirile 1,000 nika ka luck. There's no luck. Understand? There's no luck in FX. If you don't work for your own shit, nothing's gonna come out. So you just need to work, and work. Understand? If we keep posting good things, get motivated, don't hate. You understand, guys? Let me tell you something, guys. Invest 8 hours a day. Invest 8 hours a day on the charts and tell me if it doesn't work for you. You're gonna come to me and say, "Man, underdog, thanks for everything." You understand, guys? So it should be that simple. But then you can't keep investing boom at 30 minutes on the charts, then you go around saying Forex is a scam. Forex is not a scam. If you search "Man Under the Goat Dog," you'll see my YouTube channel. It's there. So guys, Forex will never be a scam, and Forex will always be there. You understand? So when people do God, celebrate with them. And Nasdaq, guys, Nasdaq is not a currency. Respect Nasdaq, because everyone now what's genie, you know my sign name, Kukina. Bless dog, guys, you know, guys. There are people who know my real names. Yo, psychic. But then, guys, consistency is the state of mind. Get the skill, work hard, change your surrounding. You understand me? Consistency is the state of mind. I've been profitable before. I could be profitable on the charts. You know, I told myself that I'm profitable, and now I'm profitable. But then, if you open a trade and say, "Ah, well, that trade go on my way," you ain't gonna make money. Just. Tell yourself that you are the best trader. You are the good trader, you know. Those things, like when you speak something, it comes to existence, you know. Like you're a good trader. Don't let someone never say you will never make it as a trader. You have made it before, and you'll make it after. You understand? So, but then, guys, let me not give you fake motivation. You don't work hard, you ain't gonna see consistency. You work hard, you're gonna see consistency. I can't say, guys, keep trading, you'll make it. You understand? So if I say keep trading, you'll make it, I'm lying to you. Keep learning the market. You know, I can like take a week without trading, but then I'm always on my laptop. You know, the market moves in the same way. It's just that the human mind, the human mind is powerful. The mindset is powerful. There's no way you can like get the market did a backflip this time. I made 250 today and I'm done for the day. Plus at Master BC dog, that's massive. You know, when you start thinking small, that's when big things are coming. Imagine he said he made 250. Let's say Monday he made 250. Tuesday 250, Wednesday 250, Thursday 250, that's 1K. Then it means in a week he makes 1,250. In a month, that's close like 4K, 5K. That's a lot of money. You understand? So don't let anyone dismotivate you or discourage you. Like I'm from 300, I made 1,300 from 300. You know? So never let anyone say you need to like make big money. You understand, guys? I won't forget to like save this life. Let's take it. Let's take a chill for the day, guys. Work hard. Work hard. Work hard, guys. I love you all. I'm about to end this live video. I love you all, guys. And work hard. I wanna call my girlfriend. Work hard. Zoom session, Nikiling. Dates will be dropped.